Hey there, in this video we're going to tackle the BGP configuration, and I'm talking actually about the PE to CE routing part, not the core BGP, but the BGP between the customer and the service provider network. And let me actually remind you what we've done until now. So we did this. And we're using the same route distinguisher, at least we did in these two sites, and we'll also do in these two the same route target, but we didn't yet do this. What I said is that this means that we need to configure etpath, and we'll actually do this after we're done with the BGP configuration also, to actually see this etpath feature at work. Then we've also configured the OSPF, the direct link with a metric of 100, and we've configured the sham link between routers 11 and 12, and we're done with the OSPF part. And now we can start with this BGP part, and I'm just going through to go through these, so just regular PE to CE routing, and we'll stop at about here, where we'll see that we do advertise all these loopback IP addresses, and we'll test it if we have connectivity, and I'll be back to this part after I do this whole configuration. But let's just copy the VRF part of the configuration. So if we go with config, the route distinguisher is okay, the target is okay, the new IP address, I'm looking but the link between CE3 and router 15. So here we have 10.3.15.15. And I also need to do the BGP configuration, but I'll do that on the router itself. So this is the VRF and router BGP 10. VRF Pepsi. I'll use this command on XR, BGP unsafe eBGP policy. And what it actually does, it disables the requirement to have a route policy on an eBGP session. By default, when you configure an eBGP session, so an external BGP session, you will also need to configure a route policy, and you usually configure a pass all route policy and you're good to go. But with this thing right here, I no longer need to put a route policy on this BGP session towards the customer. And I'm enabling the AF for the VRF. And I should configure neighbor 10.3.15.3. Remote is 1.2.3.1.2.3, and enable the AF for the neighbor, and this should be good. Commit this, and let's do something similar on router 16, so it's 4.16.16, 10.4.16.4. And we also need to do the configuration on the CE. So config terminal router BGP 1.2.3.4.1.2.3.4. And this is something optional, but actually I'll show you only after. So it's neighbor 10.4.16.16 remote ES10, and under the IPv4 unique host address family, I'll first advertise all these loopback interfaces as requested in the task. Okay, and also activate the neighbor, even though I think it's activated all for this IPv4 unique host address family. Show IPv4 summary, it's idle. I think I forgot to remove the shutdown command. We know it did not. Ah, okay. I'm on R3. So run section router BGP. No router BGP. I put the wrong configuration. Actually, I've put the correct configuration, but on the wrong device. So now we see the neighbor being up and will soon receive some prefixes, and we actually do. And we start learning the other CE's prefixes. Let me do something similar on CEP. So router BGP, actually let's just copy this from CE4. Copy. I need to change the neighbor, it's 10.3.15.15. These are 3.3.3.1.15. And what I actually wanted to say is that you see here that we're using the AS decimal notation, and you can actually configure this router to use the AS dot notation, and it's just this command BGP AS notation, and you have this dot option, and now you're using AS dot notation. I see this prettier here. Let me do this on CE4 also. So router BGP GP. Great. And let's see the routing table of CE4. So we do have reachability to 1.1.1.1. Why don't we do for 2.2.2.1? Okay. Actually, here we're good. Show run router GP. I think I forgot to redistribute this route. VRF Pepsi and DB4 Unicast redistribute to ASPF. I think it's one. So I didn't see this 2.2.2.1 route on CE4, and I figured that something is wrong on either the CE or the PE, but it was on the PE because I had some time between these two videos and I've modified some things. I've played with this topology and I forgot to re-put the redistribution command there. Okay, and let's see if we now receive this route. Okay, so from CE4, I can ping 1.1.1.1. I can ping 2.2.2.1, and can I ping 3.3.3.1? I can't. And let's see, is router 16 advertising this route? Neighbor and that 4.16.4 advertised routes. It doesn't. Why doesn't it do that? Because CE3 and CE4 have the same AS number and R16 figures it out, and it doesn't want to cause a loop for this customer, and Because if you check this route 3.3.3.1, this has this AS1234 1234, which I can't, it's this one here, it's in AS decimal notation, but we won't advertise a route with this AS to a neighbor, to an external neighbor with the same AS number. What we actually need to do is configure this allow AS in feature, and it's done of course on the PEs, but we'll actually, let's actually see it in this video. I was thinking to put it in a different video, but it's quite easy to show. So router BGP10, actually let me copy this whole configuration, and by the way, let me show you this thing. If you do a show run formal and do an include 10.4.16.4, you will see these commands Juniper Junos style, and I'll just put this allow AS in here. I think it's pretty neat, this show run formal command. And actually I'm wrong, it's allow ISN, I'm wrong, it's now, it's not allow ISN, but it's IS override. So allow ASN should be done on the PE, but on the CE, but on the PE you actually override that IS number with your AS number. So it's AS override, sorry for that. Let's see now if we're advertising the routes. Okay, so we're now advertising the routes, and this is before the AS override effect. And if we check here on CE4, we see that this 3.3.3.1 route actually has AS10 appended 2 times. And it's because the original AS, this one, was replaced by the PE. And let me do this on this guy also. So show run formal include 10, 15, 15. Not 15, but 3, and it's AS override. Conf T, okay. So, commit. Ah, I've just pasted. I didn't put the AS override option, so paste and AS override. Root. Show, commit. If you are preparing for the lab exam, you know root show commit, it's on your fingers. You don't even need to think about it. So now we should also see the loopback of for that. Okay, here, and if we do again this ping that failed previously, see that it's now successful, and this is the reason. But we did have another requirement here, so we're done with this. We advertise all loopback addresses. There is connectivity because we configured AS override, but we still don't have this. And I'll talk about this in the next video because it will get a bit complicated. So we're done for now. Thanks for watching and see you.